Sylvester Semugenyi, one of the participants, narrates why Kalangala is in the spotlight of the Ebola outbreak.
When you look at the setting of islands around Kalangala, the problem is on how we do manage the facial materials, of course, and the other wastes. When you look at landing sites, people urinate in the lake, and that puts them at risk of getting diseases like Ebola we have seen here. So we do appeal to the government. In a situation like this, maybe we can get a movable toilet.
Possessing varsity of cultures in islands, including Congolese who eat wild animals, is another cited factor, as Christopher Kakembo narrates.
Of course, we have some people from Congo. They do eat, they eat monkeys, they eat bats, and some other wild animals. So we encourage people to stop eating those wild meat from the animals like bats, monkeys, and so on.
These have been trained by experts from the UNICEF on how to handle Ebola recovered cases.
It is to continue to follow up on these survivors to make sure, first of all, they counsel them as part of the survivors program. If you're a male survivor, they counsel you, they counsel your family. If you are married, they talk to your wife on what? Safe sex, how you can continue to live so that you protect yourself and you also protect your what? Your wife. So we talk to them about safe sex using a condom.
Alice Maguba, a health educator, said that these trainings are still going on and they hope to host one next for the remaining leaders.
This is just the beginning. The trainings, I can say that maybe every after 2 weeks, because now we are here, we have just met few from just only 4 sub-counties. Now we are meeting with the other sub-counties of South Sakia within this island, the sea. So, according to our plan, we have another meeting next week with the other remaining sub-counties so that we empower them with knowledge and skills to fight Ebola in their country.
Rajab Semakula, the district chairperson, applauded the government of Buganda for this initiative.
To sincerely thank the Buganda Kingdom through the office of the Pokino of Voodoo for, among others, including Kalangala district on the program sensitization on Ebola infection.
He appealed to leaders to disseminate this information to everyone within their reach.
We use this forum to disseminate this information to the concerned. We are going to disseminate it to the BHTs, disseminate it to the cultural leaders, to the religious leaders, so that something can be done to prevent or to check the possible case.
This is the first of this kind that engages leaders under Buganda Kingdom structure, mainly on preventing Ebola as tourists storm islands for festive leisure. Story compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.